We have seen till today that is what, suppose if user is providing the wrong username or password, then we say that it is invalid username or password. But we were checking for the static username and password. And that is what, if user provide admin, then we are simply opening the calculator application, right? But this admin is a static over here. This is static. It means that it is fixed. Now I want to provide the facility to the user for the sign up the username and password, and that I want to store into the file. And whenever user sign in, I want to check into the file instead of this static admin. So what we can do, simply first we can think about how we can provide the sign up facility. So it is very simple. Here we can take the one more button, and that button is B2. And here we can create the instance of that button. So I am just creating the instance of that button is, that is B2 is equal to new button. And here you can write that this is the sign up button. So I need to add the button. So I'm just adding the button number 2 over here. And here we can set the bounce of the button. So I'm just writing here b2.setBounce. You can mention your x over here. So x is 120. Y will be changed because I want to put this sign up button after the sign in. So here you can set y is 170, width is 80, and height is 30. You can save this. Now you can compile and run your code. You will get here one more button, and that is the sign up button. Whenever user click on this button sign up, I want to ask to the user that enter the username and password to register. It means that I want to create the another frame, right? So I want to write the code whenever user click on the button number 2. So here we can write the code in a button number 2, and that is what, b2.addActionListener. Here you can create the instance of ActionListener, and here you can call it anonymously the function that is public void action performed. And here you can pass the instance of action event. It means that if the button number 2 is called, then I want to create the another frame, and that frame is the sign up frame. So here I want to call the sign up frame. So before that, I need to create the frame, and that is the sign up frame. So I'm just creating here one class, and that class is sign up. And here you can create the class which extends from JFrame. So this sign up is my class which extending from JFrame. Here you can write the constructor, and here you can set the layout that is null. So what happens whenever you add any control in sign up, you need to set the bounds. Here in a sign up, I need the 2 text field. So I'm just creating the instance T1 and T2, and I need the one button, and that is for the submit. So I'm just creating the button that is B1. Definitely I need to initialize. So I'm writing here T1 equal to new J text field, and you can provide the size. You can write here T2 equal to new J password field, and you can provide the size. And you can write here B1 equal to new J button, and this button is submit. I want to add the control T1, T2, and button. That is the button B1. Now I want to set the bounds where you want this text field and button. So I want to just set that set bounds, and you can write that I want the x is 100, y is 20, width 80, and height 30. You can simply copy text field and button. This is text field number 2, and this is the button number 1. I want the text field below the text field 1. So you can set the y that is a 60, and you can set the y that is 100 over here. Now, whenever the button is clicked, that is the button number 2, I want to open the sign up frame. So, very simple, you can simply create the instance of sign up over here, that is sign up s equal to new sign up. And here you can say that s.set visible true. And you can set the bounds of your frame. So I'm just setting x 200, y 200, width 500, and height is 300. So what happens whenever the button 2 is clicked, sign up frame will be opened. Now you can compile your code login demo.java. I'm getting the error that the cannot find the symbol. Yes, I need to write here new keyword. Now you can simply compile your code and you can run this. Now whenever you run this particular code, that is Java login demo, it will open the frame that is login. Now whenever you click on sign up, it will open another frame, and this is the, you can say, sign up frame. Now whenever user enter the value over here, for example Parag and Shukla, and whenever user click on submit, I want to register that particular entry into the file. So it means that if this button, that is the submit button, is clicked, I want to make the entry into the file. So how we can do this? It is very simple. We can write here, that is v1.addActionListener, and here you can create the instance of new action listener, and here you can override the method, that is public void action performed, and here you can pass the instance of action event. Now whenever the button is clicked, I want to make the entry into the file. So here we can simply write the instance of a file writer. So file writer is the class which is available in java.io package. So here we can write that file writer fw equal to new file writer, and here you can provide the name of your file, for example login.txt, and I want to append the data every time. So I'm just passing here boolean value, that is true. So what happened, this file will be opened in a append mode. So every time whatever you enter, that will be entered into the file. And here you can simply write fw.close. Now whenever you are using the file writer class, you need to import the package, and that package is java.io.star. One more thing is what, whenever you are using the file writer class, you need to report the exception, that is IO exception. So I recommend you to write this in a try and catch to avoid the checked exception. So you can write here catch, and that exception is exception. So what happened, this file will be created if it is not exist. Now I want to write the data, that is the text field data, into this file. So you can call the function fw.write. Now what you want to write? I want to write the username. So I am writing here t1.getText plus tab I want, and then I want to write the password. So I am writing t2.getText. So what happened? Whatever you enter over here, that is the username and password, that will be written to the file. You can save this. Now you can compile your code. Now whenever you run this particular code, you can click on sign up. So another form will be created over here. Now you can make the entry. For example, the username is, that is Tatsat, and the password is Shukla. Still, I have not pressed the button submit. Where this file will be created? That file will be created over here in the current folder of my Java project. So whenever you click on submit, the file will be created over here, that is login. See here, right? That is the login.txt, and the Tatsat Shukla is the password. Now I want that this frame should be automatically closed, and I want the acknowledgement that the registration is completed successfully. Then you can use the class, that is a JOptionPane. JOptionPane dot SoMessageDialog is the function in which two arguments you can write. The first argument is the container in which you want the message, and the second argument, that is what you want to give the message to the user. So I want to give the message to the user that registration completed successful. So you can write the message registration completed. Now here we need the instance of container. So let me create here frame, that is frame f equal to new J frame. And here you can say that this is the frame. So let me write J frame F equal to new frame. And instead of this container, you can write F. So what happened? Registration completed message will came over here. And you can simply dispose the current frame. So this sign up frame will be closed. So you can write dispose over here. Now you can compile your code and you can run it again. Now you can click on sign up. Now you can provide the value. For example, let me provide the value, that is path and password is Swadas. Let me click on submit. See, registration completed message is coming. Let me click on OK. That particular frame is closed, right? Now, whenever user provide the value over here, that is for example, Tatsat and Sukla. And whenever user click on sign in, I want to check if that Tatsat and Sukla is match with the file content, then I want to open the calculator application. Is this Tatsat Sukla is available in file? Yes. You can open the file and you can check. There are two records. One is Tatsat Sukla, another is Partha Swadas. But I want to press enter after writing the record. It means that I want to store the record in a line by line. So what we can do over here? Here, whenever you write the data, after writing the data, you can write slash F. So what happened? The record will be written sequentially line by line. You can simply remove this file, that is login.txt. Now you can compile your code and you can run again. Now you can click on sign up. You can provide the value, for example, Tatsat Shukla, and you can click on submit. The registration completed. Again, you can sign up and you can provide the record, for example, Parth Swadas, and you can click on submit. Registration completed. Now you can check the content into the file. So here, whenever you right click and add it, you will get the two records. Tatsat Shukla, Parth Swadas. So you can say that this is the username and this is the password. This is the username and this is the password. Right. Now I want to match the record. It means that whenever button, that is the sign in button, is clicked in a login, it means that this button is clicked. I don't want to check the static admin. But I want to check the content into the file. So let me put comment over here. This is my static code. Instead of this admin, we will read the content from the file. So let me declare here one variable, that is boolean matched equal to false. So if the record is matched with our file content, then we will make it true. Let me get the username from the user, that is I am writing here t1.getText.toString. So what happened? Whatever the user has entered the username, that will be stored in my variable username. You can write here string password is equal to t2.getText.toString. If user has entered the username Tatsat, then it will be stored in the username variable. And if user has entered the password, that is Sukla, then it will be stored into pwd variable. Now I want to read the content from the file. So here we can create the instance of file reader, fr equal to new file reader. And here you can provide the name of the file. Name of the file is login.txt. Here you can write file reader.close. Now I want to read line by line. So I'm creating instance of buffered reader br equal to new buffered reader. So what it will do? It will simply read line by line. You can call the function read line over here. So let me create the variable string line. And here you can write the loop while str equal to br.readline not equal to null. So line by line, your every line will be read into this str variable. So it means that the username and password available into the file will be stored into this str variable. Now I will match this str with the username and password. So here we can write simple one condition. If str dot equals is the function, and here we can pass the value username, tab and password. So we know that in our file, username and password is tab separated value, and the same value I'm getting from the user that I'm passing over here. If it match, then I'm simply writing here that is matched equal to true, and you can simply break your loop. So what happened? If the content is match, then this match variable will be true. So here you can write simple one condition. If matched, then what you want to do? If it is matched, then I want to open the calculator application. So let me copy this and paste over here. So what happened? If the username and password are matched, it will open the calculator application. And if it is not matched, then we will simply put that message invalid username or password in a label. So in a label, I will get the message invalid username or password. So this is the way we can read this. But whenever you are using the file reader, you need to catch the exception, and that exception is the file not found exception. So here we can write this particular code in a try and catch. So here we can write try, and here we can write catch, and that exception is file not found exception, as well as I need to write the IO exception. So I'm writing here exception E, and you can write this code in a try. Now you can save this. Now you can compile your code. I'm getting an error just because of this comment. So let me remove this star slash. You can save this. Now you can compile your code. I'm getting an error, and the error is str equal to read line. It means that this should be my line variable, line equal to br.read line. And if line dot equals username and password, then I want to do the same. Now you can save this. Now you can compile your code and you can run this. Whenever you run this, for example, let me write here, the username is, for example, Ankit, and the password is, for example, Faldo. Let me click on sign in. It says that invalid username or password. Let me sign up the value that is Ankit and Faldo. Let me submit this. The record is inserted. You can say registration completed. Now you can click on sign in. It opens the simple calculator. It means that once you register the person, then you will be able to access the application. So this is the way you can develop the login application in Java.